You've arrived at module 6. We're adding interactive features and polishing off our report designs. So when it comes to interactive features, there are four things you might consider doing to your report. You could toggle visibility to achieve drill down and drill up behaviors. You could add links, either to jump within the report or to other resources outside the report. Mm-hmm. Interactive sorting could be added, and tooltips, minor but sometimes very important to convey additional information to your report users. Now, just a word here about rendering formats. Now, not all rendering formats are going to support interactivity. The one that supports all of the features will be the HTML rendering.
Correct.
Now, if your report needs to adapt to the render format, then we have the render format object that allows us in expressions to interrogate. Is it interactive format, or specifically what render format is being used? Therefore, in your expressions, you're able to do things with visibility, or turn off features that just aren't useful or helpful in a particular rendering format.
Yeah, there's some cool tricks you can do with that in Power BI. Like, for example, with subscriptions, you can have an attachment that's in a PDF format and you get an image preview. You can actually have the image preview with a different view than what you get in your attachment.
All right, all thanks to expressions.
That's right.
So let's begin with the toggling of visibility. This makes sense with the tablex when you've got groupings and nested groupings. And so there's a property on text boxes, but also on groups, that allows you to control the visibility and to toggle the visibility by other items on the report page. Note that toggling visibility works only for reports rendered in HTML or Excel. Links can be added to let report users open other reports, or jump to other locations within the same report, or simply to launch a hyperlink, maybe to the company's intranet page.
Maybe go to the intranet page, but more importantly, maybe go to another paginated report or a Power BI report and use something like URL parameters.
Right, and URL parameters will be introduced in our next module, module 7.
Stay tuned.
All right, so types of links include bookmark links to jump within the same report and hyperlinks to go anywhere else. Interactive sorting, this applies only to reports rendered in HTML, and again, working with the tablex. The ability for the user to click on the group header or the table header, and then to control sort order according to your own expressions. What I do like is that you can achieve multi-column sort. A lot of people don't realize this, but by pressing the control key, you can then select the columns in the order that you want. For example, sort first by first name and then by last name.
Yep.
All right, and then finally, the fourth approach, using tooltips to add additional information. They can be applied to all report item types except the line. I can't imagine why you'd want a tooltip on a line. but report users must hover their cursor over the report item to reveal the tooltip. For this reason, it only works in reports that are rendered in HTML. So let's see this by finishing the design of our sales performance report.